said you all needed somebody to go down the steps, right?
Oryk already went down.
Oryk already
Yeah.
went.
Everything was on tables too high for him to see what was on them.
Moving in that direction.
Gonna hold your action.
Yeah.
Thumbomez.
Well, the Miz will also delve into the thing. There you go. And he will use his bonus action to stealth poorly.
Oryk sees him.
Yeah. He's going to peek around the corner here.
Emerald.
We're in a spiral, guys.
No. Check out the wardrobe.
Right, do you open it?
Yep, swing it open, bang the doors against the side. All right, punch it.
Right, you find a wardrobe and it coughs at you. It contains 10 nobles' clothes and a cape. All very fine.
Oh, very fine. I'll grab that up, I think. I have to do an identify with you sometime.
So you grab all the clothes.
Yep.
Right. It's kind of bulky. It will keep you from doing a double move, but otherwise you can carry it.
Yeah, I could throw them in the pack.
It's a lot of clothes.
Time up in a bundle. Hobos do it all the time. I got a quarter staff tied at the end.
You might ruin the material. All right, do you
But
need
they're
anything
being
else?
transported. Not sure. Grab them. He's got everything out of that. I think everything is checked, except for the bed or the rug. Let's be thorough. I'll move here to investigate the bed and or
The bed has very fine silken sheets. And
I'll take out.
the rug looks very expensive also.
I say we'll roll everything up in the we're taking it all.
What is Emerald's strength?
I didn't say he was carrying it all.
Okay. Oryk. You see that one of your companions has joined you downstairs.
Okay.
You're not sure where everybody else is.
Well,
everybody else is rolling down bed sheets and rolled up rug down to them. Say, hey, taking this.
wait a minute. Get me.
Yes. Dancing Bear actually goes first.
Oh,
Next.
okay.
I assume Dancing Bear picked up some of the spell components.
Well, that's the next thing I was going to run over to look at if no one else did.
Head down there with them.
All right, you find a very crowded little passageway with Oryk right in front of you. All right, Oryk, it's now your turn, and you're flanked on each side by companions.
Bye.
arbalest at the ready. I don't see anything threatening. I'll stop right there. And oh, that doesn't look pleasant.
Oh, you can't see that. Mayhan.
The smear is less concerning than the giant pool.
Alright, we got everything off this table, right? On that table?
You haven't grabbed anything yet.
No, son of a bitch. Well, his pack's empty. Just sweep the table into his pack.
He's got a scroll in one hand and a goblet in another.
That's right. I wanted to try that goblet. I'm going to have a seat on the bed here and dip that goblet in the water.
You try to sit on the bed, but Emerald's pulling the sheets off the bed.
All right. How about this? I flip over the bed to see if there's anything under it.
So you flip the bed into the well of water?
Sure. Yeah, that should rip those covers off real quick.
All right. Emerald seems very sad that now the silken sheets are soaked.
But there was nothing hidden under the bed.
Nope.
Now I can dip that goblet in there.
All right. You have a goblet full of water.
I take a drink into the goblet.
You're no longer thirsty.
All right.
And you feel all fancy.
I hand the scroll to the wizard as I walk past him. And
his hands are full with clothes, packing, and trying to roll up a rug. Sengo.
Yes, I'll tuck that in my waistband.
That's half your movement. Would you like to double move, or are you gonna hold an action?
What's half of my movement? Ain't it?
Yeah. Well.
Well, it was half of my movement to get onto that square. So how many?
You had to difficult terrain to get past Mayhan, and then it was slow going down the stairs. So you can double move to continue moving.
Then I guess I'll have to double.
Okay. And it's difficult terrain moving through those two other allies of yours to go around the corner.
All right. That I didn't realize.
So, to move here, it would be 30.
What's that?
Because this is difficult terrain, so that would be 10. That would be 20. 25. 30.
Oh, yeah, I can go all around that. I didn't understand. I didn't realize that either.
Okay. The moment is...
I guess there is a line there.
Yeah, a little wall.
Yeah. Sorry.
No problem.
Film looks like those little cubicle setups.
Yeah. I'll see, that looks so awesome whenever you do that. I forget how to do it every time.
Fimblemiz is going to just kind of look around. Obviously, the out-of-the-ordinary bit is already somewhat apparent here. He's trying to discern if there's anything particularly threatening about the giant pool of blood.
Hold on, I'm trying to find my orb. Alright, after navigating a tight spiral, a large well dominates the east end of the room. It's filled with blood. Some fresh blood can be seen on the floor on the west side of the pool. The walls have large scrape marks on them, and rubble lays in piles on the stone floor.
You said it has large script?
Large scrapes on the mark. Large scrape marks okay. on the wall.
Gotcha.
Is Fimmelman's done?
Yeah, he's just gonna hang out in case anything comes in stabbing distance.
All right, Timurl.
Wait for the others.
Could be a while.
Because Emerald's trying to clean up all this good shit up here. My interact, grab my ink and parchment, and then head down the steps.
All right. Dancy Bear.
I always find comfort having like a square clean player.
I peek around that corner.
Look what you dug up. Found your old friend.
He looks
happy.
Unhappy, yes.
Does a 24 hit you?
Yeah, it does.
Does 9 points of biting damage. Piercing, I assume. And then he does 10 points of slashing damage, and then another 23 slashing damage.
Oh, well, okay, good night.
Good night.
So Orc probably didn't even get a chance to yell out an alarm there.
Oh, you're pretty sure a dancing bear is screaming right now.
Loud thud of you hitting the ground.
I hope you're going from dancing bear to clawing and biting bear.
Mayhem. You hear a commotion from down the stairs.
Yep. I have to go see what's going on. Head down the steps there.
Alright.
Give me the whiz bang.
10, 15. So that's 15 points of movement, or 20 points, 20 feet of movement to get to there.
30, 35. And I would just get in front and impede his movement, so I will stop her.
Alright. Sengo. You hear something's going on around the corner.
Oh, wait, no, he could double move. I will double move.
Okay.
10, 20. And get to there, see what's going on there, and back right back up.
All right, Sengo.
Get to there.
Such a wise decision on Sengo's part.
Hold on. Carrick, you actually only take 10 points of slashing damage. You couldn't have do all those. Carrick, or. Auric, you only take 10 points of slashing damage.
What was the biting damage?
No, it didn't bite and it didn't do its second slash. It just did the one slash as its reaction. So you just take 10 points of slashing damage.
Yeah.
But anyway, that apparently shocked you and you weren't able to react after that.
I guess.
Back to Sengo.
Now,
second attack hits. Okay.
I'm going to follow it up with one of these.
That will hit.
And one of those.
That will miss.
Two hits, probably.
Yep. And.
I'd also like to use my second.
Your second what?
My second wind. That might take an action. So I'm okay.
Okay.
Happens as a bonus action.
Nice. So your maximum hit points is down, what, 8?
Yeah.
Okay. And Mayhem's down like 14?
Yeah.
9 of that 12.
Okay. All right. As you sort of heal yourself, you notice that the creature that you just damaged seems to heal itself also.
Oh, goody.
Now it will bite and claw at Auric. Does a 12 hit Auric?
I don't think so. No.
Does a 13?
No.
Does a 16?
Yes.
It'll take 9 points of slashing damage. Pimmelmiz.
Blast some acid. So they just make other ranged attacks.
that affects it. Emerald.
Going down the steps.
That's 10 feet.
20, 30.
All right. Dancing bear. Dancing bear says, sees Emerald come around the bend with just a crap load of crap.
Dancing bear sees what?
He sees Emerald come around and he looks like a, like, he looks like a Sherpa. He's like just, he's got this huge pack behind him.
Great. Hey, glad you can make it, man. We got trouble down here.
He's like, I got sheets.
I'm all set for next rest here. I got a lot of shit to work with.
Alright, Dancing Bear backs himself into a corner.
Danced himself right into a corner.
Okay.
So that'll be what?
Either a strength or dexterity attack, I guess.
What's that? Use your action to make a spell attack with your fiery.
Okay.
Spell attack. What's that mean?
I think if you go into your character sheet and go into spells, I think you can click on.
I believe I have that written down on my wizard.
Spell save. DC spell attack bonus 5.
Yeah. Roll a 20 and add 5
spell
to it.
Spell save attack equals 8 plus your proficiency bonus plus your intelligence modifier.
Except he is his wisdom, doesn't he?
Yeah, being a druid, it's probably his wisdom instead of his intelligence. So 8, 10, you get a bonus of 2 right now. So 10 plus your wisdom modifier.
3.
So your spell save attack would be a 13.
Well, it's not a DC save, though, is it? Just roll a d20 and we'll add stuff to it.
D20 plus, yeah, 2 and 3 plus 5.
So it says my spell attack is 5, so.
Yeah, plus 5, yeah.
So 9 will miss.
Be a 14.
What?
No, it'd be a 9.
Oh, 4 you rolled. I thought you rolled a 9.
Okay. Orc. Thought you were dead, but you don't feel quite as dead yet.
You thought you were dead, but now you feel the pain. So you realize you're not.
So I haven't even actually attacked yet this combat. All right.
Just been sucking up all the blows.
One will hit. You're firing your.
Oh, no. Yeah, sorry. No. I'm in melee range, so it would just be the hand axe.
Okay. So, how much damage does it do?
7. It's still the. I don't know why it puts the damage below that, but it's 7 slashing.
Anything else?
No, just wait for the sweet caress of death.
Man.
Yes. I'm going to... Dang.
I just gave it to her.
Charge right up here where I belong, right up front. And I'm going to swing my stick at him.
Hits.
And my key.
Those both miss?
Both miss, son of a bitch. Must have sprained my wrist or something, not getting these bitch slaps in it.
Sun go. Ten. Yes. So 10 points of damage.
Cool. Pinned in there.
And it seems to. Its wounds seem to close. It will bite after Auric again. It's a 17 hit.
Oh, yeah.
So you take 6 points of damage. Piercing.
Okay.
Does a 10 hit you?
Me as well?
Yes.
No.
All right. Fimmel Miz.
Ugh.
7 will miss.
I'm going to use my inspiration.
All right, roll again. That will hit. What kind of damage would you like to do?
Acid. You basically threw a shiny grenade at him. Blast acid everywhere.
Okay.
That's his turn.
Emerald.
And 10, 20, see nice people covering it all over.
Actually, I had a quick question. Is there, how's this area lit?
See a light back there.
There is a light source there. There's a light source there.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
there's all the corners.
And
that's
there's
all
a
I cared.
Glowing door there.
Okay. So it's not dim light. So never mind. Proceed.
We're on 16. Use the second level slot.
Alright. Anything else? I guess you can't.
No,
move.
I think I will just wait right there. There's a line of people in front of me.
Dancing Bear.
Alright, well, his.
Yeah, I think you have concentration for a while.
Yeah. So, that's what I want to do again, is try to hit with that. That's a nice chunk of damage.
It'd be like a scimitar attack.
That will hit. Looks like you're kind of stuck in place. Orc.
Alright. I will draw my second hand axe.
Alright, first attack hit.
That is it.
Man.
I might have to step to here. Just because I'm thinking this might keep it from healing up some.
How often can you use your breath weapon?
Breath weapon.
Then you have to take a short rest.
I don't have that info here. No. I do not know. There's a limit to it.
Let's see. Dragonborn traits. Breath weapon is a short or long rest.
I do have to take a rest in between.
Yeah.
All right.
You use it once.
Knock him again. But is it like the troll? You gotta burn it to keep it from healing?
I'm assuming that's what's going on since it keeps healing.
Yeah. That's what my idea was. Alright, let's try this again. Quarter staff. 18 for 10. Slap. Slap.
One hit. Hey,
20 hit him. That's good. Let's see what I can do. Spend my key point. And I will turns.
Is my hand done?
I will attempt to knock that thing prone. We'll succeed on dexterity saving throw or be knocked prone. Which should give everybody else advantage on their attacks until it gets back up.
What's the DC save?
You say DC 8, 10, plus one wisdom. 11. 11.
Alright, that's fine.
Alright, made a save. Yep. Faster.
Sungo.
Well, now. Is it knock prone?
Nope.
No. No. I tried it. Did not work.
First one did.
Still alive, John. I ain't got nothing else.
Alright. It is down. Do you want to move?
Was the modifier.
Okay, you there?
Yeah.
square I'm in.
And it raises. And it focuses still on Oryk.
Jeez.
Does an 18 hit you?
Yes.
Take 5 points of piercing damage from its bite. And then it looks over at Mayhan and slashes. Does a 13 hit you?
Yep.
You take 15 points of slashing damage.
I think that puts it down.
And it continues on, looking at Dancing Bear. And Dancing Bear takes 10 points of slashing damage.
Dancing Bear hit him with flame. Shouldn't that have kept him from healing?
Yeah, who knows? All right. Thimble Miz. You can make a check if you want.
A check?
If you want.
What do you mean?
It sounded like Emerald just said, hey, isn't fire supposed to keep it down? So you can make whatever
check
kind
would
of
that be?
You can, you choose. Your Arcana check says typically trolls are kept down by fire and acid. Fire and acid don't seem to be keeping whatever this is down. So you think maybe you have to use some other thing.
Another spell slot.
Okay.
What's that?
You have to try something other than fire or acid.
Oh, blood.
No, let's use.
So 25 definitely hits.
Yeah.
So you do 34 points of what?
Is there anything about this troll-ish looking creature that seems out of place from a regular troll?
It's not a regular troll.
Well, that doesn't help. No. It's not like undead or something.
No.
Guess we'll try cold damage.
That's what I was thinking of, putting my armor Agathys up as I go up. That deals cold damage.
Yes, this particular creature needed cold or necrotic damage.
Interesting. And that's why I took Chromatic Orb, you never know.
Yeah, I got that one too.
Does Fimbulmiz want to move? As you do see a glowing door similar to the one you saw before in the last dungeon.
Yeah, but there's a chest inside it.
Yeah, that's what I'm more concerned about.
You do see a chest. Dancing Bear, do you see a dragonborn laying next to you?
I see two characters. So...
Yeah, I imagine Fimble Miz on his next turn. Help his friend up.
Hold on.
chest come first?
No. Going to one of these out there. Plus, spell cast modifier.
So, who do you choose? A creature.
Oh, yeah, a creature. We'll get Ed's creature, Ed's character first.
That's a bonus action though, so you can do your main yet.
Yeah, that's right, huh?
So, 7 points.
That was a bonus action. Over here.
So I got the small one, right? 7?
Stabilized.
I'm stabilized.
What's that?
Got you stabilized.
Oh, okay.
And there will be heals on the
map. I got you 14 points.
Alright, Mayhem, you can stand up.
Yep, stand up, jump on the troll corpse now. Slot him a few times.
Alright.
Trying to make way for some other guys to get through.
Let's him go.
Whew. Let's open the chest.
Alright. See what room this is.
Is it, does it open?
Yeah.
Or is it locked?
No, there don't be, there doesn't seem to be too many locked chests in this dungeon.
He wants us to succeed.
Yeah, until we get cocky.
Until we get cocky.
Oh, sorry, keep inspecting everything before you open it.
So are you guys gonna exit the door once you open the chest?
Yeah, probably. Heading to bed here soon, though.
So you do that, and Emerald identifies?
Yep. Deck of Illusions.
Ring of Jumping. Ring of Jumping. Bracers of Defense. And a Cloak of Protection.
Was that cloak in the chest or in his armful of things?
That was all in this chest.
So you got all those robes and stuff, do they glow?
One of them does.
Alright. The rest can be sold in town. Along with these fancy sheets and rug.
Actually, you could trade those things to the, what you call it, guy?
Oh yeah, I could do it that way too.
And then back in the room with the whites and the wraith and the water well, it's those things. Gold and healing potions, spell components.
Oh wow!
Noble's clothes. Cape of
Did
Minor Invisibility.
Already split up the gold from that or something?
Yeah. Well.
Gold and healing potions, I remember putting on my sheet.
Fimbulmas gave everybody, I think, 600 gold pieces. And
yeah.
Two healing potions. But that's correct. All the other crap that Emerald collected, I think. And Dancing Bear collected some spell components. And I guess he did not pick up the urns with the... I guess that's not there. Ever-burning torches. Those are still back in the dungeon.
Yeah, I wasn't hauling that around. I moved to see if anything would happen. Yeah, that put me up to 10 potions for my monk.
So, I will calculate experience points and let everybody know what those are.
Alrighty.
I'm sorry I didn't kill anybody this time.
Tried your best, though.
We might be fourth level for the next dungeon crawl.
Most likely, I'll let you know.
All right. I'm gonna jet here, fellas. I went to bed at 2 and got up at 6, and I haven't slept since. So
our extra life doesn't correspond with this, right?
What's that?
Our extra life won't like interfere with this weekend, right? Or 2 weeks from now, right?
Not sure.
So that's like a month away still. Or 3 weeks.
It's, it's 20. Well, no, it would fall normally on this.
All right, well, I'll play things by ear and post on Facebook.
Yeah, I mean, we still have 2 weeks from today that we're not doing it.
Okay.
2 weeks from, 2 weeks from today is the third.
All right. Well, thanks for playing tonight. I'll see you guys later.
See you next time.
Later.
Yep. Ciao. See you guys. Been fun.